How did you, my gorgeous friends on the internet? Can I just wave like a normal human being? Why do I present myself with my arms straight? Hi, Ahmed. Today's episode is about TypeScript. And let me tell you a little story. This is for people that want to learn TypeScript and haven't gotten into it yet. Or maybe they're just at the beginning of their... Are you at the beginning of your journey in TypeScript? Because you better be, because it's important. But let me tell you a little story about myself. I've put off learning TypeScript for the longest time. And I really regret it because it has helped me so much in writing better code, understanding my code, and of course, having the benefits of types. But I've been avoiding it because I didn't feel like there was a clear route or path for me to learn it, especially because when I went online on like Twitter and other platforms and social medias out there, when I looked at initially at TypeScript code, it had generics, it had T's and crosses and union tabs, and I felt like I was joining a cult. So this video is intended to show you that you don't even really need to write any TypeScript to reap all the benefits from it. So let's head onto the computer and show you some TypeScript. One nice thing about learning TypeScript in 2023 is that you don't even need to do any setups. So if you're using Next, or maybe you're initiating a Vite project, whether it's vanilla JavaScript or maybe a framework, it all come with TypeScript setup for you, even SvelteKit. So that's fantastic. So here I just did a vanilla JavaScript Vite project and I made two folders. So we have a danger, that's JS, and a save.ts. So again, to create a TypeScript file, you just add the .ts extension here at the top and done. And you essentially get two things with this. One, you get the compiler, the TypeScript compiler, that's gonna do type checking for you. So in this case here, this function is gonna expect an object, right, that takes in an X and a Y that are both numbers. So here, when we're passing down the numbers, the compiler is gonna do a check on it to see if that matches up. And if it matches up, everything is fine. However, if I change this to expect a string, then the compiler is gonna flag that and throw you an error. And it's gonna say, hey, look, X is incompatible here. Type string is not assignable to, type number is not assignable to a type string. So it's gonna notify you of the error that you're about to make. And another thing that comes with TypeScript is the TypeScript server, which is essentially gives you language services. So like autocomplete, and like when I type person here and I do dot, like I get to see all the properties that I can use here, right? Name. If I wouldn't have the language services, so if I just mark this as a person any, and if I type person, as you can see, I don't get any of that. I'm essentially telling TypeScript pack its bags and get out of here. So this is very funny of JavaScript. Let's see, we have a current balance here of 100 and I'm trying to withdraw. So I just made a little function here that essentially withdraws the amount that we pass here in the parameter, and then we just console log it out. So I'll go and do a withdrawal, and we have 100. So let's do 25, so I'll pass 25 in. Cool. And let's have a look. And if we look, we have 75 left. So you might be like, cool, everything's done. Let's move on to the next part of the code. But what was going on here? Look, I passed a string and it worked. Where I'm actually like, I wanted to pass in a number. So if I do 25 here, that works, right? It works the same way. That's the problem here. That's a real problem. It works the same way. So that's quite the funny thing about JavaScript, is that I can pass in a string here and it's not gonna complain. It's just gonna silently turn it into a number for me. But that could potentially cause so many problems because the behavior is just unexpected. You never know what you're gonna get. So when I paste this code into a TS file, you're already gonna see it's gonna flag it up for me and say, hey, careful, this is a type any. And that just essentially means that, well, could be a string, a boolean, an object, anything. So what we can do here is head to the parameter and I'll just mark this as a type of number. And now when we hit save, as you can see, I cannot pass 25 in as a string anymore. So it's gonna warn me and say, hey, this is expecting a number. So let's change that to 25 and that's it, done. This is all the TypeScript code that we wrote. One of the fantastic things about TypeScript is in a lot of cases, you don't even need to write any types. So if I do a counter here and set that equal to zero, if I hover over it, as you can see, TypeScript automatically inferred the type for it. So it knows it's a number. So you could go and write number, but that just becomes a bit redundant. But what I really want to emphasize is TypeScript is so useful for catching these funny JavaScript bugs that you just would not notice sometimes. In this case, look at this. We have a person here. It's me, Ed Tillman. And I have a function here that just formats our name for us. So we pass in an object here with the first and last name, and then it returns us a string, right? With p first name and p last. And then we call the function here, so it's gonna save it into this formatted variable, and then we're outputting it down here. But then we look in the browser and we see that it's undefined, and then this is what you see loads of times in JavaScript, right? Undefined. Why is this undefined? Why is my thing null? God damn. This is why you need TypeScript. So what is the problem here? Well, I mistyped this. I typed first name. I should have passed in first. So if I change this, then you're like, okay, that works. That's fine. As you can see in TypeScript, our P now, our parameter that we need to pass in is any. Again, that's not good. That means that, well, you can make any mistakes you want. That's how I want you to remember any mistakes. So you can create either a type or an interface. So we can do, let's do a type. They're pretty much the same. Some of them have features that the other ones don't have. I can maybe cover it in a different video. I'm running out of time, goddammit. So let's call this person, all right? So we know that it needs a first, so let's do a string of first and a last name of string and Coolio. What's happening? Where's the equal sign? Equal, cool. So P now is a type of person, all right? So just add the colon and person. Oh, look at this. Now TypeScript is actually telling us, hey, property first name does not exist on type person. Now, again, that might seem a bit like vague and whatnot, but you just need to kind of get used to reading these errors. But essentially what's saying is that, hey, first name is not exist on the type that you provided. And if we check first name, oh, well, yeah. There's no first name, it's just first. So it gives you a clue. It gives you a clue to fix it. And in most cases, you don't even need to type out types like this or interfaces here at the top. I know loads of people say, oh, but TypeScript adds quite a bit of boilerplate. Well, in most cases, you can get by just by having the types inferred, like here at person, or here in this case, in this function, you could just add it here straight on by without making a separate type here at the top. Here's another funny thing that could cause problems. Let's say that the parameters you're passing in here are fine. So we know a type of string, but let's say your calculation here leads to something bad happening and you're gonna return 5. You're gonna return a number and not a string. And as you can see, we don't get any problems and it says everything is fine and dandy. Now it does automatically infer it, see? So we can see that formatted here is a type number. So that's fantastic. But if you explicitly want to say, hey, this format name expects 2 strings and the return, the output should also be a string, you can also specify that here by adding a colon string, like here after the what's it called? The parentheses. So now it says, yo, get that shitty number out of here. Put that string back. Okay. I just like TypeScript for the fact that it gives you so much clarity on what's going on in your code. I can do 2 parameters here. Let's say your second parameter here accepts 2 different types. So it could be a number or a string. So I can do that using union types. And here, if I tried to just return x plus y, you might make this mistake. It's not gonna let you. As you can see, if we hover over it, it says that we cannot use the plus operator on types number and string. So it makes you write better code. It makes you check if the type of y triple equals string, and then we could handle this case specifically. I'll just return 0 here. However, here, now if I do an x plus y, that is fine because we handle the case, our potential issue where our second parameter might be a string. Now again, this is not a real world example, but you could see how that would cause a problem. But one of the best things about TypeScript is that it's just so easy to incrementally adopt. You can just change your extension to a .ts, and then in your ts config, you can use these 2 options to make the process a bit easier. No implicit any. If you turn this to false, this will not complain about any of your parameters or variables. And then you can start adding the types to it and eventually just getting rid of it completely. And there's another one that I really recommend turning on at the beginning, which is strict null checks. So you can imagine like if a user is like either a string or an ID or null, it's handling those types of cases. So thank you so much for watching this episode. I'm going to link the official docs. That's a great resource to learn more about TypeScript. Of course, I'll make more videos on it if you wish. And also a good book is this one. What's the title? I forgot. Effective TypeScript. Sorry, Dan. Effective TypeScript. 62 examples of potential problems that you might run into. And there's more. It's just not in the book. Thank you so much for watching. Until the next one, heads out.